Ang nakikita kong problema ay ang mga opisyal ng pamahalaan na siyang nagsasabog ng kasinungalingan. Yun. A number of government officials, politicians, and other public figures tend to play fast and loose with the facts, in the process misleading the public. These lies spread easily owing to the big following and wide reach of these public figures, including on social media. Social media, yung Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, are just platforms. Na-mention na ito kanina, I think natas ito kanina ng chairman. They are vehicles for communications. Whether they are constructive or destructive, it depends on us, on how we use it. Now, nakikita ko sa bill ng SB 1492, yung kay Senator Villanueva, an act penalizing the malicious distribution of related violate and of related violations, yung platform ang sinisisi at paparusahan. Parang hindi ata tama. Accountability should be on the sources of falsehood. Ang mahirap nga dito, minsan sa mga reporters, kapag nagbigay ng sinungaling na pahayag yung isang official, siyempre ikukot namin yan as accurately as we can. Eh, magagamit pa ngayon ang reporter sa pagkalat ng kasinungalingan at ng fake news, di ba? Now, what is deplorable in official spreading falsehood is that they are doing this on taxpayers' money. If there has to be a new legislation on fake news, the onus should be on government officials who are the sources of falsehood, who use government resources to spread them. And this should cover the personal blogs of officials. Because
ma'am, which? Like who? Please cite.
I will cite to you the, yun na lang yung kay President Duterte, yung bank accounts ni Trillanes. Yun, inamin niya later on na fake pala yung ginawa niya. But it was reported, di ba?
Sino po niya?
Presidente.
Ah, okay. Pero ginamit ng...
Siyempre, Nika, di ba? Pag magsasabi kasi ng sinungaling yung presidente, kasi kami sa Verifiles, niya we track false claims. Ang dami yan. Every day, every week, at least mga... Ang makakaya namin siguro mga... Ilan ba yung magagawa? Four? Three or four na mga false claims ng mga public officials at saka not necessarily basta public officials and personalities. So, pag sinabi kasi ng isang official yan, pag ikaw reporter, ang ano mo talaga is you quote as accurately as you can. Diba? Ay, problema na ay kung lies pala yung binigay sa iyo ng ano ng official, do you quote the lie accurately and then you make a news report out of it. Ay, lie pala yun. Di ba? So, di kasama ka ngayon. Ang mangyayari ngayon, it's a challenge to reporters eh.
Oh, so ma'am, when the president uttered that and then later on, it wasn't verified properly, did they make a correction in that site?
Oh, ano na yun ha? Kaya niya inamin na pigment daw his imagination yun nung nabuko na siya, di ba? So, isipin mo, di ba, nagkalat ka ng kasinungalingan. Yun ang, di ba? Tapos, yun, ginamit mo pa yung reporter sa pagkalat. Ngayon, yun ang problema ng reporter kasi we are supposed to write to report truthfully, yung accuracy, di ba? Yung isang-isa kasing element ng news is that it has to be accurate.
Pero ma'am, you know what? You already reported accurately what the president's uttered at the time.
But what you report was a lie.
But what you reported, but you didn't commit that lie. So later on, you can do further research to substantiate or to disprove.
Oo.
I mean, no, but I know what you mean, ma'am, your predicament. And especially, the PCOO will have to report live or to report word for word what is uttered by the president because they're under the office of the president.
So yun ang point ko.
Should they make the correction also?
Yun ang point ko is that ang problema ng ang legislation should... Yeah, the burden should be on the source of falsehood because we should not be spreading lies.